If you realize that all things change, there is nothing you will try to hold onto. If you are not afraid of dying, there is nothing you cannot achieve. Haoussou. Fear covers our bodies in shame. Love enables us to stand in glory. Fear glorifies violence and death. Love glorifies peace and life. Fear holds into. Love let it go. Fear disempowers. Love empowers. Every step in your life is motivated only by one of these two emotions, love or fear. You have no other option to choose from. However, you have the ultimate control which one to pick. The only trouble is that, you know, through our century, we glorify and celebrate the fittest, and as well as the triumph of the strongest and also the success of the most intelligent among us. You know, hardly any is said regarding the splendor of the most caring. Therefore, you wish to be the fittest, the toughest, and the most intelligent. And if you see yourself as something less than the fittest, the toughest, the most intelligent in any kind of scenario, you feel less worthy and you fear the idea of losing, because you believe winning is that matter. And to win, you have to be the best, the greatest, or the strongest. Just think for a moment and you will certainly see that it is in fact the truth. Our core motivation is based either on a feeling of love or feeling of fear. That's all what there is. That is the motivation beyond all motivation. There is the feeling behind the feeling behind the motivation. It is the first motive. It is the ultimate necessity. It is the ultimate pressure. It is the ultimate power that drives your life. If you have ever built a relationship, it is out of love. If you have ever destroyed a relationship, it is out of fear. Our surrounding condition us, say you should love those who are close to you. You should fear the stranger. You should love your parent. You should fear the police. That's why we produce the same again and again. We go to length to build love, and then as soon as we build it, fear comes along and destroys it. That's why, for instance, when you say to someone, I love you, and you start worrying whether you will hear, I love you too, but, and if you hear it back, next thing you worry about, that the love that you just found, you may lose it. So you go into defensive mode. You try your best to defend the love that you just found, not to lose it. And jealousy come along and grab you. Therefore, your action become a reaction rather than acting toward doing the loving. And if that is your first time here in my channel, you have yet to subscribe, please press the subscribe button and the little bell next to it so that you will receive the video as soon as they come out, and also support the channel. You choose fear to motivate you, to lead you, contrary to what God teaches us. We know from God that with action of love, we will do more than just survive. We will do more than just win. We will do more than just succeed. And when this is done, then we will experience the full glory of who we really are or who we can be. God is love. Fear is evil. The choice is yours and will always be, because you are motivated. So the question is, what motivates you? Love or fear? If you find this video useful, give me a thumbs up by liking the video. And if that is your first time here in my channel, you have yet to subscribe, please press the subscribe button and the little bell next to it so that you will receive the video as soon as they come out, and also support the channel. God bless you, and I'm looking forward, you know, to bring you video next. Thank you.